Why are expensive antennas often cheaper? There's a whole business case here, and I'm not going to go through it in detail. The principle is very simple. I say to people, and this is often a bit shocking to them, that in 80, sometimes 90% of cases, an absolute useless antenna will perform the same as a very well-designed pointing antenna. Now people say to me, if 80 or 90% of bad antennas as good as a good one, then why the hell should I pay three or four times more for a well-designed antenna? The real answer is there. If you've got, for example, with tracking, we've got guys that's got 50 to 100,000 vehicles out on the road. Say we use 100,000, and 10% of them don't perform well. That's 10,000 vehicles that you have to go refit. 10,000 customers that's most probably not happy. And you may find a good antenna would give you good performance in 98% of the cases. So what I'm always saying, that's why field tests are also pretty meaningless, because like I say, 80 to 90%, you're going to see another antenna doing pretty much the same as our antenna. But 90% is not nearly good enough, and the costs of actually going to fix it, just the direct costs, whether that's credit card machines or anything else, is much, much larger than the saving that you make by buying a cheaper antenna. That's the direct cost. Just please consider that we design IoT systems not because of the mounting and things like that. We do stuff with them. We process credit card payments, we track cars, and what is the cost associated with that not working? In other words, the main overall system cost is another factor that's not even sitting in here. So I really encourage people, that's often the lowest cost item in the system. But as I've said before, if you look at the standards, there's absolutely nothing a guy can do with a modem to get a better link. These things are governed by standards. The only thing that can make a difference to the system you provide from a link perspective, I'm not talking about the fancy interfaces, protocols, error correction, I'm talking whether the link works or not, is the antenna. A modem cannot make a better link because it is governed by international specifications. So your only difference is actually your antenna. Why would you actually sit and skimp on that in terms of links?